Shalom YouTube, this is your Ark. Yah is Magnified, coming back with another video. This video is titled Penalties of Non-Response. So with that being said, let's get to the subject matter at hand. Okay guys, I was looking at this video on YouTube today. You know, it's kind of sad. It's a sad situation or a sad story. You know, I'm gonna play the video. But basically, you know, matter of fact, I'm just going to play the video and then we can discuss it as it go on. But watch this, guys. Pay attention to this.
This judgment is so old and the fight so new in court that this man's only choice may be to pay the $65,000 to support a child that isn't his and who he's only met once last year.
Did you guys hear that? They said this man got to pay $65,000 for a child he met once. That's not even his. Crazy. But let's see how he got into that bind.
Gabriel Cornejo came to Harris County Family Court hoping he wouldn't have to leave common sense at the door.
I've never thought that in my life I would have to defend myself of something that I'm innocent of.
Cornejo is a father. He's raising his three kids and two of his brother's children. But last year tells us a deputy showed up at his door with court papers claiming the state of Texas thinks he has another child.
She turned out to be 15.
So who made the claim? The state of Texas made the claim that he has another child. But, man, a guy named Gino, you know, we was going back and forth in my comments, and he stated that Texas can't make a claim. I mean, a state can't make a claim, or an agency cannot make a claim. But, you know, this is just further proof that they can make claims, you know what I mean? But they can't make claims to you, the living man, but they can sure enough make claims to your fictitious person, your straw man. You see, guys? So, like I said, paper to paper, flesh to flesh. So, let's continue.
16 years old at the time, I think.
Cornejo claims he never knew and pretty much immediately set out to meet his then 16-year-old daughter for what he says was the first time.
It's a wonderful girl. Very smart. Just a lot going on for herself.
He, his wife, and the ex-girlfriend he broke up with 16 years ago all agreed he should get a DNA test, and he did.
Well, the results came in, and I'm not the father.
But that's not the end of the case, not even close. Cornejo's ex still wants the money, and so does the state of Texas.
So his ex want the money, and so does the state of Texas. I wouldn't give him nothing. You hear me? They'll have a hard time getting that $65,000 from me if I was in that situation. Him, I put him right up out their misery. Quick, fast, in a hurry. But let's continue looking at this. It's a sad situation, but let's finish looking at it.
In 2003, Cornejo's ex-girlfriend went to court and said Cornejo was the only possible father. The state of Texas got what's called a default judgment and started assessing child support payments.
So the state of Texas got a what? A default judgment and started assessing child support payments. But how did they get a default judgment? Because he never responded back to the summons. So when he didn't respond back, they automatically, because I guess he figured it was going to go away. He probably like, that ain't my kid. I ain't paying him nothing. They ain't going to no court. And by his non-response, now this man is $65,000 in debt for a child that's not even his. But let's finish.
Which continue to add up, now totaling nearly $65,000. Cornejo says he was never told. Court records suggest, but don't prove, he got a subpoena way back when, and he denies it. Lawyers for the mother of the child suggest support was taken from Cornejo's paycheck long ago, and Cornejo never fought it. That can be enough to establish a Loctite claim that Cornejo should have dealt with this long ago.
So you see that? Because they was taking child support payments from his check, and he never disputed it. That automatically gave the state of Texas the claim. You see, guys? So by you not responding, you end up in more trouble than, you know, trying to hide or just send the mail back, you know, and all that other stuff. Nah, man, open your mail up. Face these people head on, man. You know, face your enemy, man. Face your fears. You hear me? You can't keep running from the boogeyman in the closet, you know, because when you open the door, you realize it was never nothing in there, you know, and you can't keep letting the bully come and beat up on you, man. Child support is a bully agency. And they, you know, they try to bully you out of your money. You see? But, hey, when you stand up to your bully, he'll leave you alone. You just got to stand up to him. you know, but ducking and dodging and hiding, you know, sending your mail back and all that. Nah, because they get default judgments that way. Because they can prove that it was sent. If you returned it, then that's your rejection of the mail. And once you reject the mail instead of responding back to it, then they move further on with their claim, further putting you in debt and, you know, basically putting you in dishonor. And when you're in dishonor, guys, you automatically lose in the court of law because you are the one bringing controversy into the court. You see? Well, the only thing you had to do is agree the way you want to agree. You see? It's a powerful thing to do, man. You know, it's a way out of any contract. Know that for certain. But I'm going to continue to, let's finish listening to this. And then we'll do the little closeout.
Don't stick your head in the sand because it's not going to go away. And there can be consequences even if you don't do anything.
Unfortunately, this young child is the one who suffers.
Unless he and his lawyer can...
You heard what that gentleman said. Let me go back. Listen close, man. That's what I've been telling y'all. He's telling you the same thing. Now listen right here. This guy right here.
Should have dealt with this long ago.
Don't stick your head in the sand because it's not going to go away. And there can be consequences even if you don't do anything.
Unfortunately.
See, he said the exact same thing I just told you guys. So by you not responding back to their claim, then you become an acquiescence. And that's what happens. They act on their claim. So with that being said, guys, y'all continue to fight, you know. Don't give up, man. We can all win. We can all get out of this situation, man. You know, but you guys got to want to get out. You guys got to stand up to this system, man. You know, it's the system, man. It's not the lady too, or it's the female too, because she went down there and got help. But it's the system that's doing all the enforcement. You see, it's them coming down to lock you up. Your child mom ain't coming down there to lock you up. You know, she going down there and complain, but they come down and arrest you. You know, they the ones making these outrageous amounts of money that you got to pay them back, you know, and all that other nonsense. You know, they the one make up a debt that don't even exist. You see? So it's the system within itself, guys. And then once you know that, you know exactly who to fight. You know exactly how to come at them and put them right about their misery, man. You hear me? But with that being said, again, guys, y'all be blessed. Enjoy y'all weekend. Shalom, YouTube.